just want to talk to the 8th grade. We appreciate it. Thank you. All right, so 8th grade, Sigma, you have a double feature today. This is your second time in the auditorium. I hope that you find this assembly just as entertaining as the first one. What we'll have here today, we have our high schoolers, our freshmen, junior, sophomore, and seniors, all here to really recruit you and show you and demonstrate to you what our musical program at the Hightstown High School is like. Let's give them a round of applause for coming down here today. Just as a reminder, or actually I'm just letting you know now, we are live streaming this event, so if you want to see it, there's a part in here that maybe stood out to you and you want to check it out, it'll be posted on our district webpage by our director, Mr. Hamm. So make sure you're exhibiting our Crush Core values for the remainder of the assembly, and I'm going to turn it over to one of the directors, Mr. Hallett, at this time. Thank you.
Okay, good morning, everybody. How's everybody doing today? Awesome. I know you guys were in here earlier, so I hope this is a bit more exciting. We are, because of COVID, we were, you know, talking and decided we should bring some music groups down here so you guys can see what we have at the high school. And so I'm one of the band directors. Next to me over here is Ms. O'Day. She is the other band director at the high school. And we're going to show you one aspect of the band program at Hightstown High School. But there are three separate aspects. There are our in-class bands, which is concert band and wind ensemble. And that's a class that you can take and play an instrument. And if you don't play an instrument, you can take that class too. And then we have our after-school groups. And those are our marching band and our jazz band. Okay? Our jazz band is currently working right now. Marching band happens over the summer and into the fall. And on stage here is our Hightstown High School marching band. And this is a group that starts in July. We do about weekly rehearsals. And then we kind of ramp things up a little bit more. In August, we have a two-week camp. And then in the months of September, October, and November, we practice twice a week. And we perform in all football games. And then we compete as well. The competition aspect is primarily what we do. We put on about a 7-minute show each year. Each show's different with different music, different theme. And we're gonna perform for you some of what we did this past season. And this past season was very successful, just like many of the past seasons. We compete against marching bands across not only New Jersey, but basically every state in the northeastern United States. So New York, Massachusetts, Delaware, Pennsylvania, we see bands from everywhere. And we compete at a state championship as well as a national championship. And I am pleased to say this group, this past season, a couple months ago, placed third in national championships. And you're gonna get to see some of what they put on the field. Thank you very much, guys. And so each year, both myself and Ms. O'Day, we decide on a show. It's different every year. And this past season, we decided to go kind of the dark side of things. And we did a show called Dark Side of a Dream. It's basically a nightmare show. So a lot of the music that we used was kind of creepy. We used pre-recorded music. We also used some more modern techniques. We used a little bit of drum tracks as well. And so you're gonna get to see that today. So we're gonna perform a little bit of our show, and then we're gonna have the choir come out as well. But before we do that, I'm gonna introduce some of our sections, just so you can see what groups we have up here and what groups you can be a part of. So first is our color guard. Our color guard is primarily the visual aspect of our show. So you're gonna see a lot of that up here. We have our front ensemble right here, which they work on our mallet instruments. If you play piano, we're always looking for piano players. Behind them is our drum line. And then finally in the back is our horn line. Two tubas, baritones, trumpets, saxophones, and clarinets. And so at this time, you're going to get a little bit of a taste of what our show is. We perform on a football field, so there's a lot of visual aspect that goes into our show, but we can't do that on this stage. So you're just going to hear some of the music. So I'm going to ask that our drum majors come on up, and they're going to perform for you. Enjoy.
Thank you. program at HHS. This is the advanced choir. Okay, so we have three different ensembles for choir at the high school. We have advanced ensemble, which this is an auditioned group. Okay, then we have HHS choir, which you don't need to audition for. You just come and sing with us. And then we have the Hightstown, which is our smaller pop a cappella group. Okay, so you can think of like Pitch Perfect, that sort of thing. That's the Hightstown, okay? So, we have advanced choir and HHS choir are our two choirs that are during the school day that you sign up for. None of these ensembles do you need to know how to sing yet for if you're like, oh, I'm a terrible singer. That's Ms. Smith's job to teach you how to sing, okay? So even if you just want to come have fun, the best part about music in general, and I know this is true for band and choir, is that these people become your family. Okay, anytime you're in the building, the choir and band room is the room that you can always come to and know that you're gonna have your choir and band family there just to hang out with if you're having a rough day. They're always gonna be there for you, okay? That's just the perk of being a part of one of these ensembles. But you don't need to know how to sing at all. You can come join us. You will learn how to sing and have fun with a group like these kids that are up here today, okay? So the first song that you're gonna hear is Take Me Home by Pentatonix. That song's a little more on the pop side, okay? So it's kind of along what Hightstown would do. For Hightstown, you would have more movement and stuff as well, maybe some beatboxing. So it's not the full Hightstown experience. And then after that, you're gonna hear more like standard traditional choir type piece, okay? We don't have big fancy speakers or FX like the band does, but we're gonna do the best with using just our voices, okay? All right, advanced choir, let's do Take Me Home. Different. Before we jump into our last piece, if you are interested in joining choir. You can see Mr. Stevens, who's right here. Some of you might already know Mr. Stevens, but go see him in the choir room, right? He can help you get signed up for choir at HHS. Keep him on there. Also, if you are, I don't know if any of you are seventh graders, I might be saying something totally wrong. This is all eighth grade, you're not seventh grade. Okay. I was gonna say join anyways, even if you're still in seventh grade, but come join us instead, eighth graders. All right, here's something totally different. You're gonna hear Nellie Bly by Stephen Foster.
Thank you.
students being here today. Before we kind of end things, I do want to kind of talk about, you know, what is coming for this program next year. Probably in October, we will be performing at MetLife Stadium. So it's exactly where the Giants and the Jets play every weekend during NFL season. It's a really cool experience. The marching in here has only done it once, and that was like eight, nine years ago. But you get to go behind the scenes, you know, where those football players come out, and you get to march on that field. It's a really, really awesome experience. And then the other thing that we're currently working on, and we'll have more information around April, is our Disney trip. We go on a Disney trip every 4 years, and the next fourth year is next year. So we will be going to Disney once we get everything squared away, and I'll have more information about that the next coming months. So look, if you like what you saw today, whether it's marching in here or the choir, you know, talk to your guidance counselor, talk to your music teachers, and we'd love to see you be a part of the program in the future. And I will turn this over to Mr. Hamm, where he will give a little bit more information, and then I think that'll be it for today.
Hi, good morning, everybody. I'm Mr. Hamm. I am the supervisor for the arts here in the district. First off, I want to give a nice shout out to Ms. Smith, Mr. Howell, Ms. O'Day for bringing the students here, and most importantly, we need to give a great shout out to all the high school students coming here to perform and showcase their talents. So it's been alluded to by the teachers, this is a great family to be a part of, and Ms. Smith had said earlier that if you're in either side of the program, you are you're in a family. You can rely on, you have friends to rely on, you have teachers you can rely on, you have a safe space at school. Whether or not you're planning on continuing music after high school, being a member of the music program to any degree will really give you great experiences and will just help you grow as a person so you're prepared for the world when you do graduate high school. So we want to encourage everybody to please continue. Those of us who may have played or stopped previously, you may have stopped doing remote learning, whatever reason, it's not too late to join. Semester 2 is next week. You are very welcome to come back. We don't care the reason why you stopped. We would just love to encourage you to come back to the programs and participate. You can still have half a year in middle school, participate in any of their fun events coming up, and you'll get a chance to be well prepared as you move into Hightstown High School. So Mr. Stevens, can you give me a minute to talk about your program? And then we'll give us the same opportunity.
Hey, so like we said throughout this entire assembly, please join. That's a good time. Like Ms. Smith was saying, even if you haven't sung before, my job is to make you be able to sing better than you can now. So just come have a good time. For choir and band, our trip's coming up towards the end of the year. So for our eighth graders, we have our Hershey trip planned towards the end of the year. And then for the eighth grade choir, I take them to Rutgers, and there's kind of like a choir festival, so you get to hear choirs from all across the state becoming before one another. If you want to take a look at the choirs like next week, we have our choir concert. It's at the high school on Tuesday, and so again, 7 o'clock. So you can come out and hear what's like, what it sounds like, and what the experience is like. And feel free to come talk to me if you want to be a part of it. It's a good time.
Since Mrs. Palmieri, Mrs. McGill is not here today, so she's going to talk about the instrumental program, the band program.
Hello, eighth graders. I have to tell you something. The students that are on this stage and also the students that are in choir were sitting where you are not very long ago. You can do this. Absolutely. Learning a musical instrument and singing in a choir will absolutely change your life. And the friends that you make in band, you will have forever. The person that I used to stand in front of in marching band, I was just on the phone with her last night. I'm still friends with her. Even though she lives in Georgia, I called her up. I said, how are you doing? She said, I'm doing good. I talked to her. Friends that you make, you have forever. If you want to join band, if you want to be a part of this program, it is not too late. You can come see me. I am in the band room all day long. That's where I live. If you want to come down during academic support, I am there. Come talk to me. The new semester starts on Monday. It is not too late. I will teach you everything you need to know, so when you get to the high school, you are ready to do what these guys just did now. All right? Thank you so much.
Going to send you row by row back to period three.